Hey guys, what's up? Welcome in KK Java Tutorials. In this video tutorial, I'm going to show you one of the Eclipse hidden feature, and along with that we'll see one important Eclipse shortcut as well. So friends, here you can see I have created two class. One class in com.kkjavatutorials.clientpackage is a client program with main method, and I have a one utility class, right, which contains one static final constant company name, and another method is called utility method, or a static method is called get location, which basically returns location. So let's say I want to use these two member in different package in client program, then how we can do? Prior to Java 1.5 or JDK 1.5, how we were using, we were referring this member as by its class name itself, right? So kkutils.tk, here you can see company name and get location, right? So if I do get location, right, and here basically you have to write import as well, right? And let's say from Java 5, what happens, you don't need to refer this static member by its class name itself. So of course from Java 5 onwards we can directly refer this member, but you have to write a static import. So how basically a static import basically works, you have to write first of all a normal import, and before this package name you have to just specify a static keyword, right? And of course when you do a static import, then you have to import a member basically. So get location, and here you can see error has gone away. So that's the way basically static imports works, and that is available from Java 5 onwards. But here I'm not going to show you these things. I'll give you one tips which is basically very very useful for a Java developer. So here this import I don't want to do manually, and what I want basically, whatever member is available in my utility class, right? There is only one utility class, but in your project there might be a lot of utility class, and whenever I press Control Tab, then all the utility class member should come as a auto support, and that's the my main aim over here. So how we can do that? So what you have to do, so here is my kkutils, kkutil.java. So here I'm copying the qualified name of this class, and you have to go in the Windows. So here Windows option, right? So in Windows, then preferences, and here you have to write the Java. So if you write a Java, then I'm going to make large. So within the Java you have a many options, right? Under the Java you have a one option is called editor, and under the editor you have a content assist advanced, then favorite. So you have to click on the favorite, and you'll get a user interface something like this. And here you can see you have a two options, new type and new member. So here you can add a new type with qualified name, or even you can add a new member. So usually we used to prefer to add a new type. So new type, and here we'll have to write the qualified name of your utility class. So here I have written, and here you can see this basically member, and with the dot star means all the import will come as a auto support, and after that you have to click on the apply, then okay. Now I come to the client program, and here if I press Control Tab, then here you can see auto support is coming, right? So in my kkutil there is only two members, so company company name as well as get location. So if I want to use company name, then simply I have to click after auto support, and here you can see. Now second, if I press again, secondly I press Control Tab, then again I want to use, let's say, get location, so that is coming as auto support, and here easily I can use, and here auto support works automatically, I don't need to write it manually. That's the benefit, right? Now this is the Eclipse basically hidden feature, first of all I wanted to talk, and second thing I would like to talk about the one of the Eclipse shortcut. Many my viewers have been asking about this Eclipse shortcut, right? So here you can see I am using this static member over here, and when I do use some Eclipse shortcut, then local variable gets assigned to over here. So how I can do that, right? So what you have to do, guys, make sure your cursor is pointing on the last of the your statement, right? And if you look into this method, return type of this method is string, right? Basically that returns a string. So now you don't need to write explicitly a string location equals to get location. So you have to put your cursor end of the statement and press control exclamation and then press enter, and local variable gets assigned. So I'm going to write over here. So what I'm basically doing, control then exclamation sign, you have to press all together, and after that you have to press enter, and that's the Eclipse shortcut. Try it out. If doesn't work, then let me know. So guys, that's all I have in this video tutorial. So guys, big thank you for watching this video, and see you there in the next video tutorial.